So we're on to brakes right now, and number one, do take the tires off to do this. You're gonna feel much better. You can get access to all the bleeder valve and everything else back here. And the other problem you may come into on these old brake lines is rust. Tried to turn it and we snapped the brake line off of the back. The brake line has now been snapped off. We're gonna have to repair that line. We're gonna go get some V-nut wrenches, grab onto the back, grab onto the front, twist the opposite direction. That's gonna happen. I wanted to also show on this, you can see the clip here. This it has a lot of rust on it. This is the clip. So it has this, I don't know the technical term for it, but that's supposed to be there. It won't come off. So when you see it in the assembly, and you're taking off, you're using your wrenches, just use the wrenches in the opposite direction and it'll twist off. So we'll be doing, we gotta go make a special run for those wrenches. We don't want to round this off. These are super soft material, easy to round off, so do yourself a favor. Don't round it off because you're just gonna not be happy after that. That's where we're at with first brake line. We're gonna eventually be replacing the insides to all of this too. Looks like I have a nest up here. I'm gonna have to get rid of that. So today's progress. So you take off the center pieces. And then there is two holes right there. And you're supposed to stick the screwdriver in, compress the arm, and then turn the bolt. But since I can't find it, what you can also do is gently hammer around it. So if you gently hammer around it, evenly all the way around, you'll get to a point where you can put the screwdriver in and start prying between the two. Be careful, because what happens is the brakes are compressed up against it, so they're opening, and these are old and they're just sprung, and it's just gonna be easier for me. But you don't want to start ripping away at the brake pads inside. So just gently go around it, prying it away, and don't get too crazy. It'll eventually come off, but just be patient and work your way around it. So we're here. I have this pried up off of the gear, and now I'm shifting it up from this side. So if I were behind, I would be prying it down. In order to get the spring decompressed. It's getting a little dark here, so I'll do my best to show the direction. So here, if you have your brake drum off, you're pulling it towards you. If you're in through the slot, you're pushing it downward.
So you have that pliability back there. Now we're at another fun part. So this is completely decompressed. Now we can take it off. And then we'll be replacing this, all of these, next.